welcomes you to the following presentation of the National Football League.
This is what happened week 11 when these two teams met. It was never close. The Saints rolled over the Eagles. And today we've got both sidelines covered for you. We start with Pam Oliver, who is covering the Saints. Pam.
Hey there, Kevin. Yeah, the Saints, they completely understand. They are not about to face the same team. Sean Payton, very excited about his game plan. He's also thankful that they had that bye week. It gave players a chance to get healthy, especially along the offensive line. It gave the staff an opportunity to go back, identify whatever weaknesses they have on defense and tendencies on offense. Drew Brees probably said it best. Now it's time to have some fun. Now let's head over to Peter Schrager.
48-7 happened in week 11, and the Eagles know about it. To a man, the players, the coaching staff, they all use the same word, embarrassed. They know it's going to be a different story, and this building right now is electric. On Thursday and Friday, the Eagles practiced on the indoor bubble, and they cranked the volume as loud as it could to try to simulate the noise. But Doug Peterson said they have something very special on their team. That's Nick Foles. When it's loudest, he's at his calmest.
Well, Peter, he certainly has been in his playoff run with Philadelphia. He's won the last four games, and these two coaches, both good in the postseason. Sean Payton unbeaten at home. Doug Peterson, of course, won the Super Bowl last year. And so the Eagles won the toss. They have deferred, and so Drew Brees and the Saints will get it first. Jake Gelly will kick it off to Alvin Kamara, and here we go from New Orleans. It's a short kick. Kamara out to the eight. Full head of steam. Kamara still on his feet, and a good return by the always electric Alvin Kamara. And so here comes Drew Brees for the second time in his professional career, the number one seed. And when they played the Eagles in that Week 11 matchup, Charles, he had his best game of the season.
Just about everything he threw was on point, and he led his team, rallied them right to a big time victory. He knows it'll be a little bit different in the game plan from the Eagles facing him today, though. Expect a lot more zone coverages on the back end.
Saints will start from the 35, and they will throw it. Brees going to go deep right off the bat, looking for Gannon. It's intercepted. First play of the game. Cravon LeBlanc picks it off. And what a start for Philadelphia.
We're saying they're going to check. Did he come down with the football with a clean catch? And I believe the answer is going to be yes. What a play for Cravon LeBlanc, who did play in that 48-7 wipeout, but he had just gotten to Philadelphia, barely knew his teammates' names. Now he's got experience playing with confidence. And on the first deep shot of the game, he took it away from Drew Brees.
Well, quite a start against this secondary that got destroyed in week 11. And now it's on the offense as this building gets loud and we get to see Nick Foles. All he's done the last 2 years as an Eagles starter has gone 10-2 for the injured Carson Wentz. Throwing on first down. Four-man rush near side. Golden Tate breaks a tackle. And Golden Tate, the hero from last week, who had the game-winning touchdown catch, makes his first reception today. And so we look at Nick Foles' postseason career. His only loss was actually against Drew Brees and the Saints. That was the year that Foles had 27 touchdowns and two interceptions back in 2013.
And that was a different offense, a different head coach in Chip Kelly. He went to the Pro Bowl that year, but the Saints got him in the playoffs.
Second and four, they will run it to Smallwood, and Wendell Smallwood fights his way for a few. It's going to bring up a third down and one for this Philadelphia offense. And Charles, the one thing they did noticeably better last year was run the ball, and a part of that is injuries. Jay Ajayi out for the year, but Doug Peterson, you get the sense he knows he's got to at least try it today.
He did that last week against Chicago, kept their interest enough so he could keep his play action game alive, so he could throw it downfield to Alshon Jeffrey. I think Golden Tate will figure big into today's game plan.
Third and one. Foles on the fake, throws, and he's got a completion for a first down. It's Zach Ertz who had an unbelievable year for Philadelphia. In fact, the most receptions for a tight end ever. And on the first third down, the Eagles convert.
Let's go back quickly to something you just brought up. How much will they run the football? Last week, they showed just enough to keep Chicago's interest. What have we not seen as much of this year from Nick Foles? The RPO, the run pass option action. We just saw it there on third and short. Fake the run, got the ball in the flat to his top tight end.
Darren Sproles in the game at tailback. The ex-Saint. Fake to Sproles. Foles now going to throw it to Sproles. And Darren Sproles gets to the edge, up to the 49. He's got a gain of 5 yards. The Saints defense, Charles, you know, you think the Saints, you think their offense is great, and it is because of Drew Brees and all the weapons they employ. But this defense, especially the last month, was really good.
Yeah, they illuminated that on our pregame show. Coach Jimmy Johnson was talking about how well they play the run, and that's going to play into this game in a big way. How much will Philadelphia try and run it, and how much will they show run and throw short passes that equal runs?
On second down, here comes pressure. Foles in trouble, gets it off to Smallwood. He's got blocks. Smallwood fights his way for a first down. Boy, that was a good play by Cam Jordan because he had a lot of room, but it is a Philly first down.
How about that? They caught him in a blitz. Looked like P.J. Williams and Nickelback came from here. Now watch this. If Cam Jordan does not make this play in space, because there's Williams right there, he gets to go a long way. He's got Brandon Brooks, number 79, out in front of him. That could have gone right down the sideline.
Smallwood gets it on the carry and breaks through. Smallwood with a good hard run, and he's going to have 8 yards. Think about the Eagles last week, and they tried to run the ball, but they didn't do it very effectively. Matter of fact, they averaged 1.8 yards per rush in that game, and they're going today against the Saints defense, which was fantastic against the rush, second in the league, and they were number one for most of the year.
And on that last run, Philadelphia caught them without their top two run stuffers inside, Tyler Davison and Sheldon Rankins on the field. They took big advantage of it on that last run.
Second and two on the fake. Here comes pressure from Okafor. Foles going to let it go. He's going to go deep. He's got Jordan Matthews. Touchdown, Philadelphia. It's already different than week 11.
When we talked to Nick Foles, he talked about understanding his receivers, understanding what they could and could not do, and putting the football in spots where they could get it and no one else. We use the term throwing people open. That's exactly what he did there with Jordan Matthews.
Elliott with the extra point. It's a 37-yard touchdown to Jordan Matthews after the interception by LeBlanc. What a start for the underdog Eagles. LeBlanc on the first play of scrimmage for New Orleans did that. And then the Eagles go right down the field and the bomb to Matthews, and it's 7-0 Philadelphia. Well, the Eagles started exactly how they wanted to. An interception, they go right down the field. Nick Foles, 5 of 5, 5 different receivers, and a beauty of a throw. 37-yard touchdown to Jordan Matthews, and we'll show you how it happened in a moment. As this kick, Kamara will take a knee, and they will start on the 25. Charles, how did it happen?
So P.J. Williams has the coverage, number 26, the Nickelback. But watch what happens as he gets downfield. He ends up losing sight of, he doesn't know where the football is. So right there, he's looking here, but Nick Foles is looking here. See, P.J. Williams sees it, loses sight of Matthews, loses touch with Matthews. But you saw the second vision arrow? Nick Foles saw that open area and put the ball there and said, Jordan Matthews, go get it.
So now it's the Saints. They'll give it to Ingram, who had a nice day against Philadelphia last game. Here, no gain as Michael Bennett was in on the tackle first.
I've been in that spot before as a defensive back, and what happens is you're trying to locate the football, but you believe you can feel the receiver. P.J. Williams lost the feel, couldn't find the football, but Foles knew exactly where to put it.
Second and 10. Four-man rush. Breeze going far side of the field, and it is incomplete. He was trying to get the ball to Ted Ginn. And Rasul Douglas was out there on the cover. So a third and 10 will be coming up. Charles, we started talking about it. Well, last time they played, the Eagles secondary was an absolute mess. They had injuries to the starting corners each of the last couple weeks. Things have solidified. Again, they're playing not full strength, but they've had time to play together. Look at the Saints offense. And notable here is that man number 72 on the left, Teron Armstead. He's been battling a pectoral tear, practice all week and playing, and that's good news because he's great on it. Third and 10. Here's Breeze under pressure, going to go deep again and incomplete. He was looking for Michael Thomas, who led the league in receptions, but stride for stride with him was Avante Maddox.
You know what else is already different from their last meeting? Is that these defensive backs that you were just talking about, they've already made three plays on the football downfield against the receivers that didn't happen in the first meeting. So right away, they're being challenged in a way that they're unaccustomed.
And two stops for this Philadelphia defense. Here is the punt by Morstead. It's a boomer. Darren Sproles running up, false fair catch, going to let it bounce. And it goes out of bounds around the 26-yard line. 9:51 to go on the first. Philadelphia with the early lead, and they've got the ball when we come back. Welcome back to the Superdome. Spanish language broadcast available tonight on Fox Deportes. Glad to have you with us. NFC Divisional Playoff. The number one seeded Saints off to a bad start. The Eagles have a 7-0 lead and the football. Nick Foles and company at the 25. Pitch it to Aguilar now, and he's got room. Nelson Aguilar, first down, as he's got 11 yards on the run.
So watch where they line up Nelson Aguilar right here in a slot position, a tight position, and he just goes back against flow. All flow is this way. He goes back the opposite. Look at Jason Kelsey, number 62. They're all pro center. Get out in front. Nice block on the corner by Alshon Jeffrey, number 17.
Eagles go three wide with Smallwood, the back. Here is Smallwood. Good hold by Smallwood, and then it closes rather quickly, but he's still got 4 yards. You know, Charles, I go back to Dennis Allen, the defensive coordinator for New Orleans. He's done a great job, right? This defense got better as the year's gone on, but he said, I thought something interesting to us the other day. He said, what scares me is that they already have an aggressive play caller in Doug Peterson, and really they've got nothing to lose.
Yeah, when you play a team like that, now you expect them in key situations to go for it more on fourth down, to take bigger shots downfield and run some of the misdirection we've already seen.
On second down, blitz coming. Foles sees it, unloads it. It's Golden Tate who's got a catch for another first down. So already Golden Tate's involvement with a couple of catches for him, and he picks up 12.
One other thing Dennis Allen told us is that it's hard to get to Nick Foles because he has a good delivery and gets the ball out of his hands. So you need to disrupt receivers, get up tighter on them in routes. Well, in that play, they were not up tight on him. Eli Apple was playing an off coverage, able to run the route in front of him was Tate, and Foles was able to deliver.
Wendell Smallwood, who's running hard to start this game. He's got another 5 yards. So he's got 4 carries for 19 yards when you consider the Eagles barely rushed over that last week. Already a better scenario for them.
And how about what we're seeing from Doug Peterson as a play caller already? How many different formations have we seen in a short amount of time? The different alignments, the different looks, faking it inside, throwing it to the flat, showing a power formation and running it as they just did on the last play, trying to keep the Saints defense off balance.
Second down. Foles has time, lofts it to Aguilar, who should have another Philadelphia first down. And Nick Foles has a lot of time to throw the football.
I think that goes back to their ability to run it successfully early. Cuts down on the pass rush.
That's Sheldon Rankins, who had a career year 8 sacks for him, and right now he's the injured Saint. They'll tend to him. 7:04 to go in the first. Back to New Orleans in a moment. Oh, this is a real shame. Sheldon Rankins was having an unbelievable year, and they had to bring the card out for him, and obviously that's at least semi-serious, and that's a big loss on the football field trying to replace him. Number 93, David Onyemata, who plays a lot, will now replace him temporarily. It's a first and 10. The Eagles have 114 yards to the Saints 0 to start this game. It's Sproles zigging and zagging his way for a 3-yard gain. Aaron Sproles, been in this game for such a long time, 14th year, had a tough year, last couple of years really with injuries, missed 10 games this year. But Doug Peterson trusts him. He said, hey, he's getting more healthy, he's going to be in there. There's the ball control numbers. Remember, the Eagles had an interception on the opening play of the game, and then a 3-and-out. Second and 7. Here's Foles, back to pass, going to go deep, and there's miscommunication, nobody home. Zach Ertz was the guy he wanted. And it'll be a 3rd down and 7. Third down, Charles, is where Nick Foles has really separated himself. I mean, the last couple years in the playoffs now, and really the last 2 years as a whole, and now the Eagles have a big injury here. That is Brandon Brooks, the Pro Bowl right guard, who, after that play was well over, tried to get off the sideline, but clearly he is now down in pain.
And if he can't go, Stefan Wisniewski will be the replacement, who was a starter for them in their Super Bowl season last year. So right here, 79, working against David Onyemata. Onyemata pushing him back towards his quarterback and knocking him off balance. And the injury must have occurred during that sequence for Brandon Brooks, who's going to the Pro Bowl for the 2nd straight year.
Obviously, concern for him as teammates kneel around Brandon Brooks. So tough drive with Rankins first for New Orleans, and now Brooks the Pro Bowl guard. And as you pointed out, Charles, Stefan Wisniewski, as a veteran, has played a lot again this year. He was a starter during their Super Bowl run this year, and unfortunately they bring out the card again. My goodness. Injury timeout from New Orleans. 7-0 Eagles lead it. A lot of emotion, serious injury for Brandon Brooks, the right guard for Philadelphia. We're not going to show it again because you don't need to see it. I'll just say it's a serious lower leg injury, and you can see Jason Peters, the veteran, there. Meanwhile, big 3rd down, 3rd and 7. Here's Foles. Has time. Going to go deep, far side of the field, and it is caught. Alshon Jeffrey comes and gets it. 1st down, Philadelphia.
At the top of the game, we talked about Nick Foles, a big-time basketball player, loved to throw the jump ball, the alley-oops to Alshon Jeffrey, another big-time basketball player. Marshawn Lattimore unable to locate the football. Jeffrey does and comes back and takes the ball away for a big 3rd down completion.
Nick Foles is 8 of 9 for 113 yards. 7 different receivers to start. And now 1st and goal for the Eagles. Foles hands off. Smallwood barreling his way towards the end zone. Waiting for a signal. Nothing yet. And it looks like he's going to be just shy. Down inside the 1.
How about the push the Eagles offensive front got against the defensive line of the New Orleans Saints? Let's see if he's able to sneak through there and get in. Massive bodies. I can't locate football or Smallwood, so I don't know how you can change anything and make the call different. That should be his helmet right there.
2nd and goal. Foles on the sneak, reaches over, touchdown! That's normally the Drew Brees special, but Foles, who went to the same high school, steals one, and the Eagles have a 13-0 lead.
As you've noted, Drew Brees so adept at
looking at the offensive line, finding a crease, and then giving a little leap over the top. Foles started low, but look how he elevates with the football over the goal line. With that 6'6" frame, he was actually all the way over before he even had to elevate the ball.
Extra point up and good by Elias. Well, we came on the air asking if this was going to be any different than week 11, right, Charles? I mean, was it going to be a different feel? Was it going to be a different look? And how would these two teams react? Well, the Saints all told us that, hey, we knew it was going to be a different game, and it's a different game by far.
Just think how it started. The Saints, we know, are aggressive on offense. They get Ted Ginn back, who didn't play in the last game. He represents their speed. They try and throw a go route to him. Cravon LeBlanc intercepts it. Tells us right away it's a different secondary than they played against when they beat them 48-7. And then on offense, the Eagles' offensive line is controlling the line of scrimmage, allowing Nick Foles time to throw the football, and also running the heck out of it against the number two ranked run defense in the NFL.
You really can't start any better. Foles 8 of 9, 113 yards, a touchdown throw, and now a touchdown run.
But remember, it's still first quarter against one of the most explosive teams in the NFL, the New Orleans Saints. Long way to go before the Eagles can get comfortable.
Kamara thinking about taking it out. He will, from 2 yards deep. Alvin Kamara gets smacked at the 15, and down he goes. And a penalty flag at the end of the play as well. DJ Alexander was there on the special teams tackle. But now let's see what the flag is with Carl Cheffers, our referee today.
And that felt like a player, knowing his team was down 14, wanting to provide a spark, brought the football out of the end zone when he should have just downed it and taken it at the 25. Despite how gifted Alvin Kamara is, probably should have downed that one.
Personal foul, illegal double team block on the return team number 42. Half the distance to the goal, first down.
And that'll move New Orleans back even more. You know, Charles, we asked Sean Payton the other day, you know, and everyone plays this differently, and you never really know, but not only did the Saints have the bye, which you like because you rest, but they essentially had a 2-week bye. They rested as many people as they could week 17. The game meant nothing, and you always wonder if you lose something there or if you gain something, and
Ready.
I don't know if that has anything to do with it, but. Here's Brees and Kamara, who gets the ball and has nowhere to go. Down to the field we go with Pam Oliver.
Well, Kevin, I watched Drew Brees when he came off the field after that last Eagles stop. He looked at his tablet for a while, then he went up and down the bench, gave fist bumps to his offensive teammates, and he just sat down on the bench and stared at the ground. We also have an update.
Number 93, defense.
We also have an update on.
That's his first foul in this regard as far as disqualification.
All right, sorry about that, guys. Meanwhile, defensive tackle Sheldon Rankins, he's back in the locker room. He's getting x-rays on his ankle.
Pam, thanks very much. So that penalty on Tim Jernigan is a big one. That gives the Saints a little room here, and Taysom Hill comes into the game for the first time, Charles.
And they get him for a taunting penalty when they have everything going in their direction and a key first down stop.
5-8. Pam, we're waiting. What's that?
Brees finds it, picks it up, and then is smacked by Malcolm Jenkins. Everything going wrong for New Orleans here in the first quarter.
Even when they gained a break from the taunting penalty by Jernigan that got him out of a little bit of a hole, the very next snap, Drew Brees has a miscommunication with Max Unger, his Pro Bowl center, and can't hold it. And let's see where the taunting is. Jernigan right here. And he's over the top of the ball carrier, throwing a little verbal trash his way. Not necessary when your team has the advantage. Stay with the advantage, don't let them up.
On second down, we got another flag.
Delay of game. Offense, number 9. 5-yard penalty. Remain second down.
And Kevin, we're seeing something early in this game that you don't see very often in the New Orleans Saints. They are out of kilter right now. They're shaken by what's happened early. They're trying to make big plays when the big plays aren't there yet. and they just can't get in sync. They've got to find a play somewhere to get this team calmed down.
Here is Breeze, second and long. We're going to get some yards, and that will help. Michael Thomas makes the catch, breaks the tackle, and he's back near the original line of scrimmage. So he picks up nine, but a third and long is coming up.
And this is where Jim Schwartz, the defense coordinator of the Eagles, has the advantage.
Mike Thomas, this year, 125 catches, led the league, most in team history. You thought last year he had a good year. He had 104 catches last year, and that was a record that he set. Then he set a new one for New Orleans.
What did he call it, the No Record Just Safe Tour? He's right.
Third and 10, four-man rush. Breeze, pumps, throws, complete. It's Thomas, first down and a big game for the Saints. So now they're getting number 13 going, and he picks up 19.
And they defended it as I expected. They just rushed the four across the front and dropped everyone else. But look at Drew Brees' movement in the pocket. Makes it up. Didn't have it the first time. Took the extra half count. Mike Thomas comes free across the middle. And Drew Brees delivers. As good pass protection by his offensive line. And a nice job by Brees going through his progressions.
That's Kamara in motion. They'll give it straight to Ingram. Up the gut, Mark Ingram runs into a wall. He's going to pick up about a yard and a half, but not much more. You know, just think about, Charles, that matchup in Week 11. Saints outgained the Eagles 546-196. Today, Philly almost there. They've got 151 yards. The Saints 31.
Not what you would expect with this high-powered Saints offense, but as we noted, still in the first quarter, finally getting their first drive going.
Leo!
Here's Breeze. Four-man rush fires, and it is knocked away. Another great play by LeBlanc. Try to get it to Ginn again, but it's incomplete.
And those are the routes that Ted Ginn favors when he's not running the goes. He likes those in-breaking routes. Watch him cut to the inside on the slant. And look at LeBlanc with enough confidence to not just play the upfield shoulder of the receiver, but enough confidence to undercut the route and go for the football. He's come a long way since the 48-7 game, as has the rest of the Eagles secondary.
Sean Payton was eager to get Ted Ginn going. He was out for a good portion of the year with a knee injury in his 10 games. Came back against Pittsburgh. Felt he'd have a big day today. They tried to no avail. Third down. Here comes a blitz. Breeze slipped. Ball is loose. Flag two. Picked up by Philadelphia. Brandon Graham jarred it loose. And the Eagles have it, but let's see what the flag is.
Backside, Brandon Graham. Does that look familiar, Philadelphia fans? Remember the Super Bowl against the New England Patriots? It's the empty hand rule. Drew Brees is not going forward. The hand comes through empty, so that's a fumble. Ball is free. And now the scramble ensues. So here comes Graham again from the backside against Teron Armstead, the all-pro left tackle. Ball's free. Now the scramble. Graham gets it, but the ball comes free again. And I think Ryan Ramczyk may have come up with it. Coming back to help out.
Didn't see him lose it there, and then it was Ramczyk. But let's see what the penalty is. At least I think Ramczyk. A long discussion on the field.
Remember, Teron Armstead hasn't played very much football down the stretch. It might be a little bit rusty. Had a pectoral injury that knocked him out.
There is no foul on the play. The ruling on the field. There's a fumble by the offense, recovered by the defense, and subsequently fumbled and recovered by the offense. Therefore, it'll be first and 10, New Orleans.
So it ended up being a huge break.
My question on this is, did they actually establish possession when the ball was picked up by Brandon Graham? Because that's what they're saying, is that the Eagles established possession, lost it, and that turns into a first down. Watch when Graham gets the football. Is this possession? Does that count? He never really clearly had that. To me, he didn't clearly have it to make a possession change. It should still be whatever the down and distance is for New Orleans.
Well, lucky for us, we have our rules expert Dean Blandino here with us in New Orleans. Dean, to you, is this a possession by Philadelphia?
No, you can see that Graham never possessed the football. He's trying to gain control of it. He never gets, remember, control, 2 feet, another body part down, have the ball long enough to do something with it. He just muffs it. There's no change of possession. So really, this is just New Orleans ball. Fumble, recovered by the offense. There's no turnover here.
So can there be a, is there a challenge on this where Philadelphia can say, hey, there was no possession change, it should be that or not?
Good question. It's automatically reviewed because they ruled a turnover on the field. They ruled change of possession, so they're going to automatically review this, and it's going to go from a turnover to just a recovery by the offense.
So that means it'll be a long distance down coming up for New Orleans now because of the loss of yardage, correct, Dean?
That's correct.
Well, yeah, after that, Charles, the thing is, it's a huge difference. Instead of what Dean's explaining, if it isn't a possession by Philadelphia, the Saints, well, they get the ball back, but it'll be fourth down because that was a third and long there. So that's why there's a pretty big call. So at least they prevent Philadelphia from recovering it deep in their own territory.
If that possession change goes through, New Orleans gets a new set of downs. They may have lost some yardage, but they would have been first and 10. And a great play by Philadelphia would have been wiped out. Brandon Graham getting it done.
After review, the ruling on the field has been changed. The defender did not control the ball, so the recovery by New Orleans results in a fourth down. Please set the game clock to 40 seconds.
Dean, as usual, on it. And so that is a big change. Saints retain the ball, but on a fourth down and long, they will have to punt it away. But Brandon Graham gets the sack and the forced fumble. The Eagles did not sack Drew Brees when they played the Saints back in week 11. Here's Morstead to punt it away. And Sproles comes up. Fair catch, call for, and he corrals it at the 30. And we'll be right back after this message from Progressive.
We're doing karaoke later, and you're going to sing.
Jamie, this is your house?
I know, it's not much, but it's home. Right, kids?
Kids.
You didn't tell me your friends were coming?
Oh, yeah.
This one is tiny, like a child.
Yeah, she is. Oh, but seriously, it's good to be surrounded by what matters most. A home and auto bundle from Progressive.
Oh, sweetie, please, play for us.
Oh, no, I couldn't. Okay.
Back to the Superdome, 29 seconds ago in this first quarter. It's been all Philadelphia. 14-0, they lead it. They've got a turnover, they've gotten a sack, and Nick Foles is off to a well to start. 8 of 9, 113 yards, a touchdown pass, and a touchdown run. Here is Smallwood on the run, and Wendell Smallwood has a gain of 2. That should take us to the end of quarter number one. So the Eagles wanted to erase that memory of week 11, and it has been a script that has been completely flipped here in the divisional round at the Superdome as we've come to the end of the first quarter. They started hot, they started fast, they went deep, they got it in from short. What they have is a 14-0 lead after one. Well, that's not exactly what you would guess as you're about to start the second quarter from New Orleans. Nick Foles' numbers, kind of what you thought Drew Brees' numbers would look like, but it's been the opposite. 14-0 Eagles over the Saints. Here at the Superdome, starting the second quarter, they've got a second down and 8. And Foles has hit 7 different receivers already out of his 8 completions. It's coming. Picked up. Foles slings it. Jeffrey, what a catch. Alshon Jeffrey with the grab. And a first down for Philadelphia after a 14-yard gain.
The Saints actually checked into this blitz. Watch A.J. Klein. See him? He's signaling. I'm going to go. And look at Wendell Smallwood step up and just stone him right there. But a nice shoulder into his midsection. And what a beautiful throw by Nick Foles. He knows that his swing forward, Alshon Jeffrey, will go up and get it. So he puts it out and away from the defensive back and says, big fella, get up to the rim and bring it home.
It's interesting. Dennis Allen, the defensive coordinator, told us, you know, we thought we could get to Wentz. Foles is different. He gets rid of it too quick, and they haven't gotten near him so far today. On first down, they will run it. It's Smallwood this time. He gets upended, and he flips over after a two-yard gain. That was P.J. Williams. I want to go back to your basketball thing, though, right? Because Foles was a tremendous basketball player coming up in the ranks. He was a scorer.
Yes.
So I find it ironic that he's kind of playing the different position right now.
You have to evolve as an athlete, and he had to evolve as a quarterback. And now all he's trying to do is distribute it to the open man and let them finish off the plays. And so far, he's doing that very successfully today with a lot of help from his offensive line. And about that blitz picked up by Smallwood.
So he's now the point guard.
Yes, he is. A tall one.
Second and eight. Saints drop in coverage. Only a three-man rush. Still pressure comes. Foles going deep. It is intercepted. Lattimore went up and got it. So the Saints defense giving a little momentum. Marshawn Lattimore with the pick. Saints football when we come back.
So check it out here. Watch Lattimore. He's going to check it out right there. And he ends up starting with Matthews and going with Ertz. But what does he do well? Sees the football the entire time. That ball was thrown a little bit short. Zach Ertz had a step on him. That's got to be thrown over the top for Ertz to make a play. He threw it a little bit short, but Lattimore had eyes back to the quarterback and goes up and takes it away. A big-time stop desperately needed by the New Orleans Saints.
Yeah, Foles knew he underthrew it a little bit. Lattimore is a tremendous player. Made the Pro Bowl as a rookie. Had another good year this year. 12 passes defense. That's his third interception of the year. And here's Breeze to throw. Has time. Near side, it's Ingram who makes the catch. And Ingram is stopped shy of a first down. But he's going to pick up 8 yards.
Remember what we talked about at the top of the game, Kevin. Yards after the catch going to be big for the Saints offense. It's kind of built into the offense without anyone talking about it. But the Eagles did not tackle well in the first ball game. And they went through a period where they didn't tackle well against anyone. Their tackling isn't improved. And what they want is, hey, if you get the completion, tackle him at the spot. Don't give up extra yardage.
Kamara in the backfield now. Give it to him. Kamara dancing. Maybe a yard, but that's about it. Brandon Graham, who's already made a big play in this game, was there to kind of blow up that play. So a third and short coming up for New Orleans.
And it's also a welcome back Tim Jernigan. They really missed him during the year. His ability to plug up the hole and maybe two holes, okay, when he's playing defensive front, makes it tough to run the ball inside when that big fella's on the field.
Saints on the year were seventh best in the NFL on third down, just one of three so far today.
5-5-3. Ready. Ready. What's that?
Ingram gets it, makes a nice move. Penalty flies. And I don't know if he got there anyway. So I think he's short, and now we see what the penalty is.
And Fletcher Cox blew that play up right from the beginning with his penetration into the backfield, number 91 for Philadelphia.
Cox saying it's fourth down.
Number 71, offense. That penalty's declined. Result of the play, fourth down.
Cox got back there so fast, that was the hold that was caused right there. Ryan Ramczyk, number 71, because he was so quick into the backfield, he had no choice but to hold him right there, and that allowed the extra penetration. There's Avante Maddox, 29, the first Eagle to get there with a host of other white shirts.
Thomas Morstead has punted more in his first half, and it's a fake, and it's a keeper, and it's a first down. So forget the Morstead punt. Taysom Hill, who does it all for this team, on the trickery.
I think Sean Payton, their head coach, felt this game really starting to slip away from his team and went for a play to try and change the momentum a little and change their fortunes. And not only did they pick up a first down, the Eagles have some concern now because Fletcher Cox is down.
Fletcher Cox Can't lose him in the middle of that line. An all-pro performer. Saints have a first down. Injury timeout here in New Orleans. So there's Taysom Hill, who's a quarterback, but the Saints have used him everywhere this year. I mean, this is from your own 30-yard line. And just remember this. It's a holding penalty on New Orleans. The Eagles declined, which you would rightfully do because it would have given New Orleans another third down. But that's a factor now. Now, the other factor on that play, Charles, is Fletcher Cox injured. You see he's walking off under his own power. Hopefully he's okay. So new life for the Saints on first down. As Haloti Ngata checks in for Cox. Flag two. Breeze sees it, throws it, completes it. Big play on the free play. It's Michael Thomas who's still going inside the 25. Taysom Hill giving the Saints life again. And Breeze with a dart to Thomas for 42.
To watch Michael Thomas, Avante Maddox gets him turned to the sideline.
Defense, number 90. That penalty is declined. Result of the play. First down.
Kevin, you remember last week they were talking about Avante Maddox struggling with double moves in Chicago? That wasn't a double move. He just got him twisted towards the sideline, and Michael Thomas ran across field, and the momentum has shifted after that fake punt call by Sean Payton.
Hey! I'm ready! What's that?
Here's Ingram, looking for a seam. Ingram inside the 20, and Mark Ingram has five. Down to the sidelines we go with Peter Schrager.
Kevin, the Eagles have another injury here. Rasul Douglas, the starting cornerback, left and is in the tunnel with an ankle injury. See how he's going to do. We have another player down right now, and Brandon Brooks is questionable to return with a leg injury. It's Michael Bennett who is down right now at the 20-yard line. They're dropping like flies here for the Eagles, Kevin.
Goodness. So Bennett is hurt. We just saw Fletcher Cox go off hurt. He has not come back in. And as Peter talking about Douglas, their starting corner, Josh Hawkins has been in this series, number 48. He's a guy that has not played much at all on defenses here, Charles.
I think they were hoping to get Sidney Jones back, who hurt his hamstring here in that 48-7 loss, trying to get him going again, but he hasn't played in a long time. So right there.
He comes up a little lame, hard to see, but right now the Eagles' best two defensive linemen hurt on this drive. Meanwhile, we'll be right back after this message from State Farm.
Ha! Surprise!
It's your MVC bike.
What's MVC?
Most valuable client.
I'm your only client.
I'm your only agent.
No, you're not.
No worries. We have great rates on motorcycles.
Oh, well, that's bad because I was going to trade this in for a boat.
We cover that too.
Hop on, Aaron. Sorry, State Farm. No third wheels. This isn't a tricycle. Jan?
Yeah.
Feels so light.
Go with the one that's here to help life go right. State Farm.
So Michael Bennett, like Fletcher Cox, walks off under his own power.
So watch Bennett, 77 in white, working right there. And then right at the end, but look who's out. Look who's not playing quarterback, Kevin.
Taysom Hill in at quarterback. Of course, we had him on the fake punt. Here he's looking to run. No, bounces out. Hill looking to throw. And Adams is going to run around the edge. And Taysom Hill, who for a quarterback is the size of a linebacker, picks up a nice run.
But it also helps if you're going to run these wildcat plays to actually have a quarterback running those plays. Because if it's a position player, they may throw the football no matter what. As you see all the different uses of Taysom Hill this year and how they did it. But in this situation, he had a pass play call, saw that it was covered in two areas, was able to tuck it down and run it because he is a quarterback and he reads coverages.
He's averaging 5.3 a rush.
You know, if that's a running back, he might throw it anyway because that's what the play design was.
He's a yard short of a first, so it'll be a third and one. They bring Alvin Kamara into the backfield.
You waiting? What's that?
Pitch to Kamara. Right, with a block from Ramchuk. First down inside the 10. Alvin Kamara so fast, he got a good block and his first and goal.
Great pickup on the play design, Kevin, because Ryan Ramchuk, he's not going to be mistaken for Alvin Kamara, but watch the big number 71 get out there and just blot out the screen of number 29, Avante Maddox. He can't see anything. And look at Craven LeBlanc downfield getting knocked down by Traquan Smith, the rookie wide receiver out of UCF.
Excellent blocking on that sweep.
Michael Bennett has come back into the game. Fletcher Cox has not. First and goal, New Orleans, and we get a flag on the handoff. No play here.
False start. Number 75, offense, 5-yard penalty. Remains first down.
That's on Andrus Peets, who has been about as versatile as you can be this year. The Saints' offensive line, they've been great, but they've really been banged up the second half. He's played just about everywhere.
Against Pittsburgh, he played three different positions. Left guard, right tackle, and left tackle. But the Saints are able to cash this in. You go back to Doug Peterson declining the penalty, which you would expect him to do at that part of the field. Or Sean Payton picking up the fake punt and changing the fortunes of this team.
First and goal. Reeves looking, lofting for Gain. He never saw it. Trying to get it to Ted Gain, who never saw it. I got to tell you, LeBlanc has had unbelievable coverage on him today.
And you notice there's a lot of hand fighting with the receivers and the DBs downfield. The officials are saying, if you guys are going to go out and see Gain gets a hand on LeBlanc, LeBlanc has a hand on Gain. That comes back to, hey, you guys figure it out, and Ted Gain can't locate the football. Second time now we've seen a Saint. Remember P.J. Williams on the touchdown pass? Could not find the football. Ted Ginn couldn't find it on offense.
Taysom Hill back in the game for the Saints. Who knows where he'll line up this time.
Tight end.
And we get a timeout. So the Saints call a timeout here to talk things over with 8:45 to go in this first half. And so much you talked about the penalty. Faking a punt on your own 30 in the first half. You don't see that every day.
And I know people are going to get on Doug Peterson. I can hear it now. How come you didn't take the penalty? You know, why would you go ahead and just let that go? Remember where they were on the field. The Saints were deep in their own territory, about the 30-yard line. It wasn't out near midfield where you might expect a fake. And Sean Payton, realizing his team needed a huge pick-me-up and a change in fortunes, had the guts to go ahead and call the fake punt. And now look at how this is working out.
Yeah, and then, of course, the big throw from Breeze to Thomas that got him going. Penalty, though, so this is the second and goal. And they're back at the 13. Here's Breeze. Pressure, steps up to avoid, throws over the middle, caught, but it's only 2-10 as Michael Thomas makes the grab. And a third and goal is coming up. There's only two Saints that have caught footballs today. Thomas now has 4 catches, 76 yards. And Ingram has the other catch. And it's quite the difference from last time when Jim Schwartz blanketed Thomas and doubled him the whole game.
Yeah, and also blitzed a lot and left other people in man-to-man situations, and guys weren't equipped to handle it. Today, handling things a lot better, having played together for 5 or 6 weeks.
Alvin Kamara lines up as a wide receiver. On a third and goal, Breeze stands in, throws Thomas the catch, but he's dragged down by LeBlanc at the 2. And I wonder if Sean Payton thinks about going for it.
Already did the fake punt. He'll think about it here. Personally, I would go ahead and get 3 points right now. Long way to go. But Sean Payton's MO is always to go get it. He's always aggressive.
Looks like they will go. The Eagles bring on Haloti Ngata, the run stuffer, possibly anticipating that.
I don't see them running the ball inside here, Kevin. That's a long way to go to try and get it done. Let's see if they did some type of a get Kamara in the backfield.
You ready for
that? Goal. Breeze. Looking to throw. Throws a fade. Touchdown. Keith Kirkwood.
Kirkwood working outside, and it's almost as if they've got a little bit of confusion in the secondary. Remember, that's Josh Hawkins, number 48 in the game, a down the line defensive back, not sure of coverage, and Kirkwood makes him pay.
You heard Peter Schrager tell you about the injuries of Douglas Hawkins there, and the pride of Neptune, New Jersey, Keith Kirkwood. The Saints convert 2 fourth downs in that drive, and we got a game in New Orleans, 14-7, Philly. So how does your quarterback slash fake punter slash tight end slash running back slash kick returner react? He likes it. And then you just have the Hall of Fame quarterback. Much more reserved, Charles.
Not so bad. Dapping it up with his number one target, the all-pro receiver, Michael Thomas.
At a time of desperation.
First all-pro receiver in Saints.
True, right?
Drew Brees.
didn't mean to interrupt, but you just think about a time of desperation, and you brought it up multiple times in that drive. Fourth down and a yard. They fake punt on their own 30. They needed life, and it gave it to them.
That's a head coach understanding and feeling his team. Sean Payton knew at that moment, hey, this thing's about to get away from us. Let's be aggressive like we usually are. Got it done, and then was aggressive again on a fourth down punt call where I would have kicked the field goal. That's why Sean Payton's coaching over there and already has a ring.
Well, you want two aggressive play callers? I'd be hard-pressed to find many more than the two in this game. So we've got a game. It's 14-7 Philadelphia. Here is the kickoff, and the Eagles will start on their own 25. Well, this February, buckle on up for the biggest race day of the year, the Daytona 500 on Fox. It's the Great American Race, and it kicks off the 2019 NASCAR season this February, only on Fox.
Joey Logano goes into the season holding the crown. Big year last year. Can he get it done in the first one?
So what does Nick Foles have in store now?
And you know what else has happened too? The crowd is fully engaged and back into this one.
Clock at two, and Foles sees it. He's got to call a timeout. You talked about the crowd being engaged. Now I think it helps force a timeout. Well, Charles, earlier we were kind of talking about Foles. He kind of took a Drew Brees play, right? Jumping over the goal line with the Reitz. It's famous for Brees. He's done it a million times, and I said they went to the same high school. They did. Westlake High School in Austin. It's a football powerhouse. Pretty amazing, right? Two Super Bowl MVPs from the same place. Foles, the class of 07. Look at those big, long rocks. And Drew Brees back 10 years before, in 1997. Brees, as a matter of fact, said his 10-year reunion. He went back, and he saw Foles there on the homecoming court. Well, fun little storyline here today. After the timeout, it's Foles. With time, they're going to swing it back to Sproles, who's got a good block. Makes a move. Darren Sproles has a first down. And so the former Saint, playing his first game back here in the Dome, makes good on a 14-yard pickup.
How about the athleticism of his offensive linemen getting out in front and holding their blocks? Look at Jason Peters, number 71. He was a tight end at the University of Arkansas. Got away with a little bit of a hook there. And Isaac Seumalo, one of the calling cards of him, is his athleticism and ability to get downfield and hit targets moving.
Extra lineman for Philadelphia, Halapulavati Vaitai. They call him Big V. And they go jumbo. Smallwood will run it on first down. And there is not much there. Cam Jordan was there on the stop. I think Doug Peterson told us he had to run the ball. At least try is what he told us. Well, Charles, so far the play calling, he's run it 11 times. He's passed it 12, so he's been true to his word.
He is right on target, too, and has kept the Saints defense off balance. They can't just load up and try and go get Nick Foles. I want to see if the Saints corners try and disrupt routes a little bit here and play a little more press coverage.
Foles, as time stands in, he's got his tight end, Zach Ertz, who makes the catch. Going to get him up to the 44, so you're looking at a third down and 5.
How about DeMario Davis, number 56, accepting the challenge of guarding the all-pro tight end, Zach Ertz. It's one of the phases of the game that's really improved for DeMario Davis. Covering receivers downfield, Ertz makes the catch, but no yardage after.
Looks like Jason Peters moved too early.
False start. Number 71, offense. 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
Watch Peters, 71 in white at left tackle. Yep, he's already going into his kick slide. Try and keep Marcus Davenport away from his quarterback. So the crowd's affected two plays already on this drive. They'll redouble their efforts on this one.
10. Four-man rush. Foles has time. Now he has to throw it away. Incomplete. No one open downfield, and Philadelphia will have to punt it away.
Kevin, watch in here, because Foles 43 comes over to block. Now watch as he sneaks out. Watch right here. Watch the intelligence of David Onyemata. He senses Foles trying to sneak out for, Sproles trying to sneak out for Foles, and he makes a play on it.
Yeah, good play, and so a punt, the first one, like Cameron Johnson. It's taken all the way back at the 11 by Tommy Lee Lewis, who gets smacked out of bounds. Up around the, we'll put it at the 19-yard line. With 4:33 to go in this first half. Great shot of New Orleans, and tell you about the night before Super Bowl 53. The NFL's brightest stars will come together to salute the best players, plays, and moments from the 2018 season. Tune in to NFL Honors February 2nd, 9 Eastern. And that's on CBS. Aerial coverage today provided by State Farm. What a shot. Cool temperatures outside, but it's perfect inside the Superdome, where it's 14-7 Eagles over the number one seeded Saints. With 4:33 to go in the half and two timeouts for New Orleans. So the Eagles defense down two starters. Fletcher Cox with a foot injury, we're told, questionable return. And Rasul Douglas, the starting corner. Kamara, right where Fletcher Cox would be for a first down for the Saints. Alvin Kamara picks up 13.
And just look at all the work in here. And right into the interior. Moves left, but look at the vision there by Alvin Kamara to see the hole back inside. They're going to run a zone play to the outside. He sees the cut back inside, and then he runs with some force as well before Jordan Hicks corrals him.
Ready, 5-8. Ready, set.
Now it's Ingram in the game at back. They fake to him. Here's Breeze on the roll. Just completes it to Josh Hill, the tight end. And Hill works his way across the 35 for a short pickup.
As a game progresses, don't you normally talk about games that flip from one half to the next, a tale of two halves? It's kind of been a tale of two quarters already here in this one, hasn't it? All Philadelphia in the first quarter. Looks like they have control in the second quarter. A fake punt changes things. And since that moment, New Orleans has been on the march.
That's Kamara, who goes out of motion now, top of your screen. Breeze looking the other way, though. Coming backside, it's Thomas, who makes yet another catch, but that is a good tackle by Nigel Bradham, a linebacker on the talented Thomas. And so it'll bring up third down.
Look at him coming underneath, a little shallow cross. Nigel Bradham trying to stay with him, staying back, wary of the speed and the ability to turn upfield. But a nice open field tackle by Bradham after the catch by Thomas. But you know, with Fletcher Cox out, that interior pass rush really gets tamped down because Tim Jernigan, Haloti Ngata, they're run stuffers. They're not great pass rushers. And now you lose that with Cox being out of the game.
They bring Chris Long in as a pass rush on a third down. Here's Breeze, four-man rush. Stands in, pressure, and Long's going to get to him with some help. Jernigan was there too, and a sack for Philadelphia on third down.
And I know Sooners say Jernigan's not a great pass rusher. He does a great play. Watch him in the middle, and then watch Long coming from the outside. Jernigan pushes. Long actually pushed him right up into the pressure. So with Chris Long's rush from the outside, as Breeze tries to step up, Jernigan was waiting to gather him.
So Jernigan and Long combining on the sack on third down, and I was going to say more set out to punt, I think, but who knows, Charles? These Saints started off with the Eagles were on fire with a turnover and two quick touchdowns. But the Saints, the number one seed for a reason. They have reset. They have got themselves back in this game. Now the touchdown to Kirkwood. 2 minutes to go, first half. Oh, it really has been a story of two different quarters. The Eagles came out red hot, but then things settle. The Saints with a huge fake punt. Story of their game so far, and then the second quarter has belonged to them. But Philly with a big sack on third down, and Morstead with the punt. Sproles racing over to call fair catch and does so at the 23. And with that, why don't we see what's up coming up at the half with Kurt Menefee.
Coming up on the Visa Halftime, Jimmy will gather all his friends to help break down what they saw in the first half. Plus, we'll look ahead to next week's AFC Championship game between Kansas City and New England, along with Christina Pink having an interview with the Patriots' James White. It's all next on the Visa Halftime. Kevin and Charles.
Karen, look forward to it. Hopefully Jimmy gets his friends. Great to see Greg Olsen in the studio today.
Yeah, they had a nice little conversation about the tight end position and what Zach Ertz brings to the table and then where the Eagles move him around.
Greg, no surprise, not a Saints fan as a Carolina player, Panthers player. So here's Foles and the Eagles, 1:51 to go. They're up seven. They've got two timeouts. Foles going to loft it near side for Jeffrey, who makes the catch. Going backwards, falling out of bounds, and he picks up a first down for Philadelphia.
And again, where was this ball placed? Over the top. Dropped it in the bucket, essentially. And there trying to make the coverage was Von Bell. And underneath, and look at the loft. Beautifully thrown football by Nick Foles. And remember, the Eagles get the ball to start the second half. Doug Peterson thinking two for one if he can get something done here before the buzzer.
Saints show blitz. Here they come from the safety position. It's picked up. Foles fires. Incomplete. He was trying to get it to Zach Ertz after the blitz was picked up. So second and 10.
Done a nice job this entire game. Have the Eagles in picking up the blitzes that Dennis Allen has dialed up for the Saints. The pass was unsuccessful, but watch the pickup. Here comes Von Bell, 24. And right there, Darren Sproles, number 43. He may be 5'6". He's not afraid to throw his chest into the play and stop an on-rushing pass rusher.
Sproles remains in on a second down and 10. Give it to him. Sproles up the middle, nowhere to go. That time, it was the rookie Taylor Stallworth. Again, Rankins went out earlier. We haven't seen him back. And a timeout by New Orleans, so they use their second timeout with 1:33 to go in the half. Well, third downs, Charles, this is where Nick Foles has really separated himself the last couple years. Today, the Eagles are 2 of 3. His numbers are just unbelievable. Look at his starter last couple years, okay? Games from December through February, 9-1. He's almost 80% on third down, which is an unbelievable number, and that's a really big reason why he's been so successful.
It has been, but that number will be tested on this down here. You're talking 3rd and 9. 80% is not anywhere what you would expect on a 3rd and 9. Let's see if he can convert.
As Carson Wentz looking on, Foles second year in a row, fills in for him. 3rd and 9. Foles tipped at the line, incomplete. I believe it was Cam Jordan who got his hands up there. He's one of the best in the league in doing that. Maybe it hit his head, but it hit Cam somehow, and the Eagles will punt it away with 1:29 to go in the half.
Yeah, Cam Jordan likes to talk about triple doubles when he plays, Kevin. Tackles, sacks, and tip balls. And there's his specialty. Another one. He had 6 in the regular season. There's another one here in the playoffs.
The Saints have plenty of time and a timeout to go. Tommy Lee Lewis back deep. It's a deep line drive kick, returnable. Lewis gets a block. Flag flies, and maybe that block wasn't so good as Lewis is up across the 25, but that may be coming back. And the signal is it will be on New Orleans. It's been a pretty clean game so far, Charles. Would you like to see? 2 penalties on the Eagles, 3 on the Saints, and we'll await the call.
Big play by Cam Jordan. And let's see what we think is the penalty. Right there coming from the backside. That's Chris Banjo, number 31. And a nice job by DeAndre Hall selling it on the backside. He really gave himself up on that one, Kevin.
Got to go all out, Charles. It's the playoffs. So here is Breeze.
Kick. Illegal block in the back. Number 31, receiving team. After distance to the goal. First down.
Well, that'll move him back. And we remind you that tomorrow, well, it's finally here, Charles. Based on the best-selling trilogy, The Passage, Fox brings you the biggest television event of the new year. Critics are calling it gripping, a thrill ride, and your next obsession, The Passage. It premieres tomorrow on Fox.
Who stars in this?
Don't know. You're just getting me to say the name.
Mark Paul Gosselaar?
That's correct. Okay. Actually, it was pretty funny last night. I had some fun with Joe Buck.
I love how Joe Buck handled it.
It was great.
You know, how perfect was that? And Mark Paul going along with it.
So here we go. Breeze back to throw. And from his own end zone, gets it over the middle, where he's got completion of Benjamin Watson, the longtime tight end. Said he's going to retire after the year. That'll be a first down. You know, kind of stunning, Charles. Alvin Kamara doesn't have a catch in this first half.
A lot of eyes are going to be on him, so Drew Brees taking the ball elsewhere. I would figure that Kamara will get involved before this thing is over. And on this drive, it'd be a prime time to get him moving.
That is Kamara in the backfield. Brees stands and fires far side. There's a completion again. Been trying all half to get Ted Ginn involved, and he got Maddox. And another first down for the Saints.
Starting to sense a little uncertainty in the secondary of the Eagles. What exactly is the coverage? Maddox has his eyes in the backfield, but he's way away from Ted Ginn Jr. Look at the eyes of Drew Brees downfield. He doesn't even have to look anyone off. He's so wide open, he can go right to his primary target.
There's Maddox, struggled last week against Allen Robinson. Saints going after him a little bit here. Here's Kamara on the run. No catches, but Kamara's going to get the carry, his fifth of the day. And he picks up six. Under a minute to go. Saints have one timeout. They've got a field goal kicker in Zach Lutz, who was hitting him from 58 in pregame warm-up. So you're talking about getting down to the other 40-yard line. They're almost there. Breeze, pressure, stands, and there's Kamara. First catch of the day, a big one. Stays on his feet inside the 40, all the way down to the 32. And the Saints are not going to use the timeout. They're going to run up to the line here, I think. And now maybe they change their mind. They do call the timeout.
Watch Kamara just clear. Doesn't have any blocking responsibilities. Scat protection, they like to call it. That just clears him out of the backfield. When you don't have to block, you can just get into the route.
And 23 yards on the catch.
And what was that Jim Schwartz told us about Alvin Kamara? What did he say about his abilities?
He said he's as good as any wide receiver in the league.
And he didn't even bat an eye on it. He talked about his abilities to run routes. Wherever you play him, he's going to be dangerous. Another example was just seen there.
So Fletcher Cox is back in the game. That's good news for the Eagles. Here's Kamara. 18 touchdowns on the year. Second most in the NFL. He tied a Saints single season record with that. You think about this, guy's played 31 career games, he's got 31 touchdowns from scrimmage. I mean, that is just unbelievable. So 35 seconds ago, Saints out of timeouts here. They're already in field goal range looking for more. Breeze, pressure up the middle, stands and throws, gonna be wide open. It's Thomas. There is a penalty flag back by the quarterback.
Cox is indicating it's going to go against their offensive line.
Holding, number 75, offense, 10-yard penalty, repeat first down.
So Fletcher Cox comes in and he draws a penalty on the first play back.
Andrews Pete, their left guard. Look at Cox working on him. Pete pushing away, but Cox has the leverage. Got down a little bit lower, bowls him over, and all Pete can do is pull him down so he can't get to his quarterback.
So that's a pretty big penalty as you look at Cox's numbers, all career highs. He was incredible. They're pretty much out of field goal range right now. 28 seconds to go. No timeouts. Reeves. Pressure coming, unloads it. It is caught somehow. There were three Eagles there. But somehow in the world, Drew Brees finds a completion. It's Ginn. And they have to spike it with no timeouts. They get to the line. And they'll do just that with 11 seconds to go. Certainly back in field goal range now.
Jim Schwartz wants to rush four and drop seven into coverage. And that works fine if the pass rushers can get home. But if they can't get to the quarterback and he has enough time, how about Drew Brees? He hit him at the end of the throw, but Brees already spied the opening, anticipated where his receiver would be, and directly put it into the proper spot. Look at Cox. He affects the play after the ball is gone. And Ted Ginn Jr. finds the open space against the seven defenders back deep.
Right now, it's a 45-yard field goal. They have no timeouts. It's only 11 seconds, and the play clock winding down. But the Eagles will call a timeout here. You know, Drew Brees, Charles, going to be 40 years old on Tuesday, right? And look, he's unlike any other. And if you're a wine person, he's kind of like a fine wine, right? I mean, the vintage just gets better the longer you keep it in the cellar. He set a new league record for completion percentage. It was his own record, by the way, from last year. Look at this, 32 touchdowns, 5 interceptions. His pass rating was the best in the league. I mean, there's not many guys that perform better on a football field as you get older, but somehow Brees has found a way to do it.
My goodness, you just rolled that out there like a sommelier. That was well done.
Wouldn't go that far, Charles.
I would say so.
Whatever's on the table, I'll usually take. So after a thought process here with no timeouts, they will just go for the field goal here. On a third down of 5, and Will Lutz has been simply fantastic on the season. You see his numbers. And this will be a 45-yard field goal try to get the Saints a little bit closer. Snap and hold are good, and Lutz is up, and he is good again. 24-year-old Will Lutz has been so steady, and so it makes it a 14-10 game with 6 seconds to go here in the half. Well, tune in on Sunday, January 27th at 3 Eastern. You can watch the NFL's best battle for AFC and NFC pride as traditional rivals join forces. 2019 Pro Bowl presented by Verizon. Well, look, I've taken the jacket off. It's hot in here, Charles. What do you want me to tell you? It really is a tale of two quarters, right? I mean, the Eagles came out. They got the quick interception, 2 touchdowns. But all of a sudden, the Saints have stabilized, and we've got a game.
They have stabilized, and one other thing has happened. The defenses aren't giving up the huge plays downfield, right? So you're not getting those quick strikes. They're both making them drive it a little bit. So when you say stabilized, it hasn't just been the offense getting in sync for the Saints. It's also been their defense doing a much better job against Philadelphia's offense. Thus, we have a game.
I have to think if you're Philadelphia, you feel like it's a win, though, right? Considering what happened the last time, considering the Saints rolled up over 500 yards last time. Much different feel here.
Even though the fake punt worked and the Saints went down and scored, I think you take a little pride away if you're Philadelphia that, hey, they had to go ahead and do that this early in the ball game. That tells me and that tells us that we are in it and we're affecting their thinking.
So 6 seconds to go in this first half. Eagles will come out. Looks like they will take a knee. And a good first half here from the Superdome in New Orleans. Yep. And that will do it. Well, the first game of the day was a blowout. Not this one. The number one seeded Saints find themselves trailing 14-10 to the defending champs at the break. And the play of the first half presented by DirecTV. More for your thing. That's our thing. Charles, here it was.
Yep. You see the look by Nick Foles, and he understands where the open area is on the field to direct his receiver. Hung in there. P.J. Williams, the defender, lost sight of the football. Jordan Matthews, the receiver, did not.
That is the play of the first half, and we'll take you to the halftime show from Los Angeles, where Kurt Menefee and the guys will take it from here. Fun one from New Orleans. Eagles 14, Saints 10. Oh, a little smirk from Doug Peterson. To L.A. and Kurt in just a moment. See you in a few. Today's game flow brought to you by Progressive. As we get set for the third quarter here in New Orleans, great shot. And it's 14-10. Eagles leading the Saints. Eagles will get the ball to start the second half. Earlier this week, Saints owner Gail Benson surprised two local NFL flag teams by treating them to a very special day at the Superdome. She congratulated them for winning their regional tournaments. The 13 and 14-year-old boys and girls flag teams were given an all-access tour of the stadium by Mrs. Benson, and they practiced on the Superdome field. How cool is that? Great stuff by Gail Benson and the Saints, NFL flag football.
Drew Brees coaches his kids in flag football.
And they're here today. That's a pretty good time. You get to play on the field. You get to come watch the game.
That's a heck of a thrill for them.
And so it really was a tale of two quarters. Eagles dominated early in the first quarter, jumped to a 14-10 lead. The Saints found their footing and came back and scored 10 unanswered in the second quarter. But Philadelphia won the toss and deferred, so they start with the ball here in the third quarter. We'll get to see Nick Foles on this opening drive. First half, well, the Eagles were committed to running the ball, and they did so better than they did last week in Chicago. Pass yards, they were so uneven after one that they pretty much evened out. Third downs is where you're surprised. The Saints are usually so good there. They struggled in that department. Started this game, the first play, Drew Brees threw an interception to Craven LeBlanc. It's only a second interception at home the entire year. Put up 14, but the Saints circle back to the fake punt at their own 30. 10 unanswered, and we got ourselves a heck of a second half on the way. And they will start with the run to Smallwood. And a short game. Let's go downstairs to Peter Schrager.
I spoke with Doug Peterson, the head coach of the Philadelphia Eagles. Said, is there a motivational speech after the second quarter? He says, no, that is not what we do. We know what is at stake. No rah-rah stuff here. We play Eagles football. Fletcher Cox is back. Also good news. Rasul Douglas is expected to be back. Brandon Brooks, the offensive guard, is out.
Peter, thank you very much. I talked about Brooks, the Pro Bowl right guard. Instead, there is number 61. He's the guy who's been playing for him, Stefan Wisniewski. And he's played a lot with this team. Charles pointed out, started during their Super Bowl run last year. Second down and 7 for Philadelphia. Play clock down at 1. Play clock at 0. And they don't get it off.
Prior to the delay of game, first charge timeout, Philadelphia.
Oh, interesting. They called a last-second timeout. Didn't see the signal. You surprised?
I'm a little bit surprised for the 5 yards here versus what maybe needing the timeouts down the stretch. We'll see.
Wow. Let's get a report on the Saints. Go downstairs to Pam Oliver.
Well, Kevin, talking to Sean Payton at the half, he told me that it's important for us to come out and build on the momentum that we were able to establish at the end of the half. He says the way the game started, we're facing a team that came out with more energy than we have, and he felt like they picked that up in a lot of ways. On the injury front, defensive tackle Sheldon Rankins, he is out with an ankle injury. Back here.
Pam, thanks. So Rankins, one of their best, not coming back. Here is Foles throwing it to Jeffrey first on the field. Short game. He's up to the 30, and it'll be a third down at about 5.
I think the Saints in coverage are going to play a lot tighter on these Eagles receivers in the second half. I think they gave them too much space in the first. They're going to make them play over the top by getting up on them and pressing them in the line of scrimmage a lot more this half, I believe.
It is loud. Third and 4. Foles with time. Going to flow one out near side of Jeffrey. And it's incomplete. It's worked a couple times today, but that time Von Bell was there. And the Eagles will have to punt it away.
And I don't believe Bell did much retreating here. He caught him early in the route and got right up into his chest. And he's going to make it be a very tough contested catch. Even though Dick Foles tried to put it up top, he had pressure in his face, so he wasn't as accurate as normal. Allowed Von Bell to make a nice play on the football and knock it away.
Saints D does their job. As Johnson will punt it away. Tommy Lee Lewis is back. Penalty flag on the play as well. Here's Lewis sprinting near side. Gets a block. Out to the 28, we'll call it. But there's a penalty way back at the 30. So let's see what this is. It was a fourth and four, so if it's an offside, it's a first down.
During the kick, holding number 42, receiving team. 10-yard penalty, first down, timeout.
That's on Zach Line. So it'll be Saints football, but that'll move him back after the hole. So the Saints come out, defense makes a quick stand. Down four, but it's their football early in the third. The Saints running the football is just a staple of what they do. You see their numbers today. They're only averaging 3.4 per carry. I know you want that to change.
Yeah, I think that this is a great opportunity for them, backed up here, this offensive line, to impose themselves a little bit and try and get some creases in the running game.
Well, they listen to you. It's Ingram on the carry, and not much on first down. I mean, you look at it, Charles, running the football, they're six in the NFL, and not only that, they run it fourth most of anybody. It really is a staple of their offense.
Certainly, you see Ramchek 71 working on Fletcher Cox, but a nice job by Jernigan 93 holding the point of attack and making it difficult to run inside. I think their best runs will be to the perimeter and to the tackles, because of Jernigan and Cox inside, they can reduce a running game to rubble.
You heard Peter Schrager say it. That is Rasul Douglas, a starting corner, back in for the Eagles. As Kamara goes in motion, here's Breeze. Four-man rush, pressure from Jernigan, incomplete, but a penalty.
And that's not going to help. I think Rasul Douglas's return will be marred by this play. So watch Fletcher Cox working inside. He and Jernigan are pushing the pocket. Look at Jernigan working on Andrus Pete. And they're making Drew Brees have to dance out to the left.
Holding number 32, defense, 5-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
So the return of Rasul Douglas, as Peter Schrager reported. But he ends up holding downfield against Ted Ginn. Remember, 5 yards is where you can have your hands on him, 5 yards from the line of scrimmage. And they got past that point, and the officials detected it. Looks like Taysom Hill here.
They'll run it to Ingram instead, right up the middle, and Ingram churning forward. And he's going to pick up 4 yards.
Did that play look like something you may have watched on TV last night, the Los Angeles Rams? They do use a lot of that jet sweep motion, a lot of misdirection. Get your eyes going one way, take the ball back another, and then they just ran a simple power play inside for good yardage. Trying to get you off balance just enough so a half of a foot, right, you lean the wrong way, gives you a good blocking angle and pick up yardage.
Breeze goes quick. Looking to throw it on second down. He's got a completion. It's Ginn on the far side of the field. And he's got a first down for New Orleans. And Ted Ginn's got his third catch of the day. You know, Charles, one more point about your running as Cox gets a breather. You know, when they met these two teams in week 11 in that game, Mark Ingram had 103 yards rushing. Alvin Kamara had 71. Today, Kamara with 26, Ingram with 12 on 6 carries. And Ingram gets a little rest.
Going to be a little bit tougher now. This is Jernigan here. That's Lodi Nada there. That's about 700 pounds of man you're trying to move.
They will run it anyway. And that's, as you predicted, tough sledding inside. And a gain of 1. As Nigel Bradham came up to fill the hole. Bradham had a great week last week, kind of spied Mitchell Trubisky, had probably his best game of the year. Drew Brees said something interesting to us. He said, you know, I think this game, biggest key for us is if they force us to be patient, we are going to have to be patient. That's kind of what's happened, right?
Take the 4-yard runs when you have them. Take the easy completions when you get them and hope you can get more after the catch to gain the additional yardage.
Second down and 9. Four-man rush. Breeze has time, no throws over the middle. He's got a completion, and he's got a first down. It's Thomas, his seventh catch of the day. It's all he does is catch footballs, 125 of them during the regular season.
And this offensive line, I've talked about them in running the ball. How about what they're doing in pass protection now? The four-man rush of Jim Schwartz, the defensive coordinator, he needs someone to get home and put pressure on Breeze. There was none there. So even if you have seven in coverage, someone will eventually come free, and Drew Breeze found him.
Time for Breeze. Quick release over the middle, and it's complete to Kirkwood, who had the touchdown earlier, tackled immediately. Kirkwood is one of those guys, one of those Sean Payton guys. You know, I think he thrives on the undrafted guys, right? The guys that are, you know, maybe not the first round draft picks. Another case came on the roster against Cincinnati and been a contributor. They signed Dez Bryant. He got hurt right away.
Signed Brandon Marshall, who never saw a down here because Kirkwood continued to produce.
Payton told us, "Don't tell me what they can't do. I want to know what they can do." And it's worked for him. On second down, they give Kamara a nice cut. Slips, though, and is going to be shy of a first. Maybe a third down and three for New Orleans coming up.
Eagles constantly rotating defensive linemen in and out of the game because it's just four rushing and most downs. So trying to get the rested guys on the field in key situations, try and get some type of pressure on Drew Brees.
Saints only 2 of 7 on third down today.
Chris Long had a sack earlier in the game. He's here at the top.
Ready for second.
Come with a blitz. He gets it out quick. It's a first down. Josh Hill, the tight end. That blitz had no chance because Breeze so quick, and New Orleans moves the chains.
And it is a tough situation when you can't get home because it's so fast, but watch how Hill gets free. Watch look working inside here. That's essentially a pick. All right, he runs the route the proper way, tries to show he's being a receiver, but that was one that they probably could have flagged because he goes inside and essentially grabs the defender and breaks him out free. But well-designed, Josh Hill gets open, and Breeze again delivers.
5-8, double, ready, ready, set, ready, set.
Fake to Ingram, Breeze has time, loads up, going deep for Hill. Maddox made a great tip to save a touchdown.
And that's another one that if the ball's thrown farther and in the proper place, and Drew Brees isn't inaccurate very often, but watch where he's going. That ball needs to come out this way. And he ends up holding up the receiver enough that Avante Maddox does not give up on the play and does his job and gets back into it and tips it away. That's excellent hustle by Maddox, but Brees knows that if he throws it into the middle of the field and puts it out there for him, it's likely a touchdown.
Now Hill is at quarterback, and Drew Brees lines up as a wide receiver, bottom of your screen. Hill, gonna throw it, he's gonna go deep, he's got Kamara, he's got it! Touchdown, New Orleans! Hang on, there's a flag back at the line of scrimmage, and this one might not count.
Holding, number 75, offense. 10-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
Wow.
So there's Andrus Peat, the left guard, who struggled with some of the pass rushers today, especially when Fletcher Cox is there. And Haloti Ngata throws him, and you see the hook right there in front. And Haloti Ngata even throws his hands up like there's got to be a flag for that one. And they caught Andrus Peat, and it wipes away the touchdown.
So a beautiful play from Hill to Kamara is taken off the board. The second holding penalty on Peat, and that one hurts.
Now watch Kamara, 41 in black. He ends up working, and it's a zone coverage. Jordan Hicks settles down, but there's no one behind him. People will say, where was Malcolm Jenkins? My guess is that there were supposed to be other people back there, and they were not.
After that, it's a second and 20. Breeze back at quarterback, sees some pressure, throws. Thomas has it. Michael Thomas. It should be a first down. We'll see where they put the football.
As long as Philadelphia's going to rush four, Kevin, and New Orleans can handle that for the most part. These completions are there for New Orleans, and look at how they're working the middle of the field. We're seeing a lot of that happen, those in-breaking routes in between the seams where the defenders are, and Breeze placing it perfectly, Thomas finding the open gaps.
Michael Thomas over 100 yards now, 8 catches, 118 yards. And so the Saints get it right back after the holding penalty. Kamara in the backfield. They'll fake it to him. They're going to come on a little trickery here as Tre'Quan Smith. And then he stays in bounds and makes something out of nothing before Douglas came up from the secondary.
If Brandon Graham doesn't make this play, and he does it, the defensive end, number 55, who had the strip sack earlier in the game and forced the fumble. Watch Graham. Watch his intelligence on this play. Works inside. Feels something coming backside, so now he goes back in hot pursuit. And Tre'Quan Smith is faster than he is, but he held him up just enough to allow other Philadelphia defenders like Rasul Douglas to get off a block and make a tackle.
Tommy Lee Lewis in motion. He's just a distraction. Kamara gets the pitch, makes a run, turns on the speed, and Alvin Kamara is going to be down near a first down, I believe a little shy. As the Saints go into that motion, Charles, that you talked about quite a bit here in this half.
And do you get the sense that Sean Payton went in at the half, looked at his notes off of his play sheet, and that's a massive play sheet, isn't it? I mean, there's a lot on there. And said to himself, I didn't have Alvin Kamara involved enough in the first half. He is getting him involved here in the third quarter.
Interesting that on third and one, two best pass rushers for Philly go out.
Ready!
It's Taysom Hill in motion.
Ready for set!
Kamara gets it. Kamara up the middle. Should have a first down, depending on the spot. But we'll see. It's close. And it is a first down. It's been a long drive for the Saints. They got the ball with, I believe it was 13:09 on the clock, and here we are 5:10 left in the third. Let's look at the ball there. You can see it. Good reach.
Right there. Good extension by Alvin Kamara. They're also on the point of the field now where the play action shot type of a play Sean Payton likes to favor.
Well,
looks like Taysom Hill's in a quarterback.
He is. And Drew Brees lines up as a wide receiver again. 14th play of the drive. There's Brees. Hill's going to run it this time. Flags fly. And Taysom Hill is going to pick up a few, but let's look at the penalties on this.
If you remember single wing football, you just saw it there. That's the old tailback.
Holding.
Sweep.
Number 60. Offense. 10-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
My college coach Johnny Majors was a single wing tailback at Tennessee and finished second in the Heisman his senior year. This would have been a staple play for him.
Oof.
And that is going to be a little bit of a phantom call. What I think the officials saw was the push of Hester going down, who was already going down, and I don't believe he ever got held. He just assisted him going to the ground. But I think they saw that at the end and felt like that was the hold and the push, and that's where the flag came in.
Well, the Saints got a bad break there because it did not look like a hold. Moves it back to first and 20. Play clock winding down. They get it off. Brees throws behind the receiver, and that almost was intercepted. Cravon LeBlanc was there. They're trying to get it to Thomas, and it's moving on to second down.
And also set up Michael Thomas for a pretty big hit, too, right here. As you see Bradham, who's trying to get the football. If he had just decided to play Michael Thomas, that could have been a big smack. But they were both trying to get the football out of the air, and LeBlanc almost came up with it. Would have been a second interception in the game.
Charles, this drive is over 9 minutes long. It's going to be the 15th play of the drive. Taysom Hill is back in the game. He's going to line up in the slot. We keep talking about how big he is, but he ran a 4-4 in his pro day. Brees, pressure comes, steps up, throws to Kamara in the flat. Kamara one-on-one. And he makes a move, but nice sound tackle by Philadelphia. I think it was Chris Long who got out there and got him.
That's what the Eagles talked about all week long, being able to tackle in the open field after the catch. You're not going to bat away every pass. They're not going to throw an incompletion. Make sure you tackle them so they don't get the good yardage after the catch.
So it'll be a third down and 16.
You know, the screen game is a big part of what the Saints do, but it's hard to do it against zone teams. They see the screens ahead of them, so I doubt Sean Payton goes to that in this situation.
Saints need to get down to the 16 for a first down. It's Breeze. Steps up to block and runs. Instead, will throw. It's caught. It's a first down. Michael Thomas again. On third and 16, they pick up 20, Charles.
And Drew Brees again, able to step up. The pass protection, excellent. No one around. And then when he throws the shot, watch Thomas. His ability to catch the football, stay on his feet, and make the extra move. Bradham unable to get him down there. That would have had him short of the first down instead. The guy who calls himself King Guard Mike picks up a first down.
17th play of this drive, and they will run it, and they won't do anything because this play will not get off. Penalty.
False start, number 75. Offense, 5-yard penalty, remains first down.
It's almost as if New Orleans is saying, let's make it even more difficult on ourselves. With a penalty, we'll overcome it, pick up a first down. Another penalty, overcome it. Here's another one here. Can they do it again? And if they don't get a touchdown with a drive of this length in time, it'll be a major disappointment for this offense.
There's a fourth penalty on Andrus Peat, and I agree. First and 15, they've overcome these yardages on this drive alone. Here is Breeze to Kamara. Behold, first down marker. It should be a first and goal. He is just so electric.
Counters and misdirections, we're seeing more and more of it in the NFL. Flo went to the left, he cuts back to the right, tries to use a straight arm. Maddox battles him and knocks him out before he can get to the end zone. Watch him throw the straight arm out, and Maddox battles it well and able to get him over the sideline before he can get to the pylon. But a good sprint by Alvin Kamara.
Longest run of the day for New Orleans. However, they bring Ingram in now.
Ready? What's that?
They're going to throw from Michael Thomas. Coming this. There's going to be a touchdown. Michael Thomas doing it all, and New Orleans takes the lead.
One-on-one route from the slot position against Crevon LeBlanc. LeBlanc sees the ball, but Thomas uses his body and his physicality to work inside and make the play. The word that comes up so often about how he runs his routes from his opponents, violently. He did it there, very physical, and took it away for a touchdown.
And the Saints have their first lead of the day. An epic 18-play drive, 92 yards. Took them 11 and a half minutes. They overcame penalties and they've overcome a 14-0 deficit. They're in front. What a drive by Drew Brees and the Saints. 18 plays, 92 yards, 11 and a half minutes, their longest of the season. And Mike Thomas is just going off. He's got 10 catches, 140 yards, and a touchdown. And the Saints, who were down 14-0 early in the first quarter, have their first lead of the day at 17-14. And this will have the Eagles starting on their own 25 as the Superdome is rocking and rolling. So it started off, but the Eagles fans were going crazy up big, and the Saints fans were like, what? But that has changed. It's party atmosphere here at the Superdome, the number one seed leading the Super Bowl champs. It is rocking and rolling in the Superdome. The Saints, after falling behind early, have all the momentum right now. 17-14, they lead. A lot of time left. 1:40 in the third. Listen to this place. They will run it. to Smallwood, who burrows his way forward for a short game. Charles, you said something at the end of the half about the Saints adjusting their coverage on the Philly receivers.
Yeah, they know that they really don't get home very often in their pass rush on Nick Foles and affect him in the pocket that way. So you have to affect the receivers. So I think the coverage is getting tighter, where they're playing more press, and even if they're in off coverage, they're not retreating very much, catching the receivers at about 5 yards and running the rest of the route with them that way.
There is Foles' red-hot start, but the offense has been quiet 52 yards since. Boston Scott is in the game for the first time, number 49 in the backfield, and now movement, penalties.
False start, number 73, offense, 5 yard penalty, remain second down.
Remember in the first half when the Saints were struggling a little bit, finding their footing, some penalties, things of that nature? The Eagles are in one of those danger zones right now. This crowd is fully into this game. They're having an effect on it. And the Saints defense has played quite well since midway through the first half.
Foles on the fake, pressure up the middle, throws as he's hit, and he's got a completion. And a first down to Zach Ertz, who has been so quiet. He had 2 catches for 15 yards. That's his 3rd catch, and it quiets the crowd for now. It's a first down.
And Marshawn Lattimore got right into press coverage against Alshon Jeffrey and took him away. But Zach Ertz, as you noted, who had been quite quiet throughout this ballgame, just his 3rd catch of the game, comes up big for Philadelphia in our key spot as we wind up the 3rd quarter.
I have a feeling the 4th quarter is going to be pretty good. What a game so far as we head to the 4th. Michael Thomas has been amazing. 10 catches, 140 yards. He led the league in receptions, and he's doing it again. Is there more Foles magic to come? Oh, about to find out. The number one seed Saints with a 17-14 lead over the Eagles. Philadelphia with a first down at their own 40-yard line. Fake to Sproles. Blitz coming. Foles going to go deep. Jeffrey fell down. Incomplete. As Lattimore was on him. Have you noticed a trend, haven't you?
Yeah, Marshawn Lattimore is now shadowing Alshon Jeffrey. Where he goes, Lattimore goes. And everything has been press coverage in the last few series. And as you noted, partner, he just tripped and fell down. There's no penalty there at all. Lattimore's in. He grabbed me and pulled me down at the end, but he wasn't going to get that call. That could be the key story in the 4th quarter. You want to get the ball to Alshon Jeffrey, you have to go through Marshawn Lattimore.
That's Darren Sproles in motion. Fake it to him. Foles gets it to Sproles. Saints converge, and he's got nowhere to go. Short gain. Well done. There's Lattimore. Charles just talked about him on the coverage there, showing the tackling. He already has an interception in this game and a 3rd down coming up.
And he came off of his coverage with Jeffrey, sees the ball in front, lets him go, and comes up and makes that tackle.
Eagles started this game 2 of 2 on 3rd down. They're 0-3 since. And they've got to get Zach Ertz going. He just had the big catch, but against the Saints this year, he's been quiet. 3rd and 8. Foles, pressure, floats one for Golden Tate. It is incomplete. He underthrew it. And Tate could not come back to get it over the back of P.J. Williams, and the Eagles forced a punt.
And I can hear the screams now of face guarding, right? That's always the call. Does P.J. Williams actually contact him downfield is the question. He doesn't know where the football is, but he doesn't run into Golden Tate, and then watch his right arm at the end of this play. Watch P.J. Williams. Actually, didn't even turn out to be that, just the ball hit him in the back. Tate couldn't come back and get the ball, as you noted.
Looking at Dean Blandino in the booth, he says that is a perfectly fine play. And the defense for New Orleans does the job. Here's the punt. And a fair catch is called for by Tom Lee Lewis. Despite the screams of the Eagles, he holds on. So the Philadelphia offense, after a red-hot start, has been frustrated, to say the least. Saints lead in their ball. 13:59 to go in the game. The Saints, number one seed, they're 13-3. If they win, they would host the Rams next week. Drew Brees, what he's done today. Well, after the interception on the first play from scrimmage, he's been himself for the most part. 21-29, 251 yards.
His completion percentage is down a little bit. I mean, he was 74.4 for the season.
It's unbelievable, right? First and 10, New Orleans. With a three-point lead.
Ready, set.
Here's Brees. Gets it to Kamara in the flat with room to roll. And Kamara out across the 20. And Drew Brees, one of the things that makes him so good, how about his vision?
Yeah, his vision, his ability to go to progressions and find the open receivers. And his offensive line is giving him time to step up, climb the pocket, and find the right guy. When you watch Drew Brees practice, he'll throw a football in practice to a receiver, reset his feet two or three times in different progressions, just so that he has that muscle memory when it comes time to do it in a game. If I don't go here, I go here, I go here, I go here. Does it every single snap of practice.
Second and five, Brees pressured, steps out of the way, calmly, coolly, incomplete. Intended for Michael Thomas, a rare miss to him. And Charles, you have to wonder, I mean, obviously every third down, the fourth quarter is big, but when you're on the field for 11 and a half minutes and an 18 play drive, you just wonder about the sea legs of the Eagles D here.
And this is a crucial third down for their defense. This series is on them. They've got to get off the field and give their offense an opportunity.
How about that number? Michael Thomas has more yards since the first quarter than the entire Eagles team. That's a great graphic.
He's come a long way. Jim Trotter wrote a great piece on NFL.com that when Michael Thomas was a youngster in Pop Warner football, he was one of those have-to-play guys late in the ball game. He didn't get many minutes.
He's top of your screen as a third down. Brees going to Smith, who bobbles. It hangs on. Traquan Smith, who had a career game against Philadelphia Week 11. I don't know how he had the strength to hold on to that football. It's a first down.
Absolutely tremendous hands. Watch Smith, number 10. He works inside, and the ball's actually thrown a little bit behind him. And Avante Maddox makes a play on the football, but the strong hands of Smith actually uses his helmet and his face mask to secure the catch, finalizes it for a big first down. Brees staying in there and taking the big hit from Michael Bennett.
Charles, keep this in mind. One other thing the Saints do well, they led the league in fourth quarter time of possession. So when they get the lead, they wear out the clock. Trying to do it again. Here's Ingram. Breaks free. Ingram, big run. Turns on the Jets. All the way down to the 26. Six yards for Mark Ingram.
There aren't many fullbacks left in this league, but Zach Line, number 42, is one of them. And how about that lead block? We absolutely paved the way for Mark Ingram to traverse deep into the secondary. Watch Line right here, 42. There's a great block. Griffin, 45 on the edge. And the offensive line created the space for Ingram to roam.
Same thing with the fullback. They give it to Ingram here, and he's going to pick up three. But you combine all the factors, the Eagles may be a little tired on D, how they possess the ball, and even though the run game's been tough today, the big one there, see, look at the time possession in this half alone.
In the last game, the time of possession was tilted firmly towards New Orleans, but that was a blowout game, you might expect it. In a game, it's a three-point game here, the Saints taking full control of the clock here in the second half. And after that last drive, as you noted, wouldn't be surprised if Saints really want to continue to play a power game running it here.
I have not seen Fletcher Cox in this drive for the Eagles. Here's Brees on a pump. Brees going for it all for Thomas. Incomplete. Maddox was there. Fans want a flag. And there is none. Third down.
It's one tough young man is Avante Maddox, the rookie out of Pitt. He's played safety. He's played nickelback. He's played corner. Got handsy in there, but these officials have shown throughout the game that they'll let the receiver and the defensive back work on each other if they believe it's equal. And they determine it to be there, and Maddox ends up winning that battle. That's a tough-minded young man. He got picked on last week in Chicago, had some tough plays here in this one, and he just battled the number one receiver for the Saints.
And a timeout by New Orleans. And so the Saints call a timeout. Pivotal play coming up, a third and seven, and they're threatening. Next Sunday, the NFC Championship game. It'll either be the Rams hosting the Eagles or the Saints will host Los Angeles. That'll be here on Fox. The AFC Championship will feature the Patriots at the Chiefs on CBS. It's all presented by Intuit TurboTax Live. First time the championship game has ever been in Kansas City.
Hard to believe, isn't it? Even though they won a Super Bowl, they were on the road then. And that timeout, while New Orleans looked discombobulated, they were able to get Michael Thomas back on the field, who had been out of the game at that point.
Yeah, Thomas in the slot. Fletcher Cox going to the locker room, as we showed you. Here's Breeze, third down. Gets it out to Kamara, who's wide open in the flat. What a tackle! Cravon LeBlanc, who's played a heck of a game, saves a first down. And now it looks like field goal time for New Orleans.
This is absolutely huge open field tackle for LeBlanc, because Kamara makes a lot of people miss in these situations. And LeBlanc takes him out over the sideline. Excellent open field play, which forces the field goal and keeps Philadelphia in a much better position.
Yeah, I would stay a one possession game. Saints lead it by three. This would be a 39 yarder for Lutz, who's got a 45 yarder so far today. High snap, nice job there. Kick is perfect. And so it's a 6-point New Orleans lead with 10 and a half to go. Foles getting ready, he's got some work to do. Great shot of the Superdome in New Orleans. And aerial coverage today brought to you by State Farm. Tonight after football, I want you to tune in to FS1 for a huge super middleweight title fight as Jose Uzcategui defends his belt against undefeated Caleb Plant. It's live after football tonight on FS1 and the Fox Sports app. So here's the stage. 10.5 to go from New Orleans. The Saints, the number one seed. They're down 14-0 early, but have pretty much dominated and grab themselves a 6-point lead. But we know what that man has done in the postseason the last 2 years. Nick Foles down by six, and the Eagles will get the ball here. Austin Scott thinking about a kick return. He's going to take it from the goal line. Scott, he's going to get to the 20-21, and that is about it. Let's go down the sidelines with Peter Schrager.
An injury update for the Eagles, Kevin. Not only is Fletcher Cox questionable to return with a foot injury, but now Jason Peters, the star tackle, questionable to return with a back injury. One note, after that field goal went in from Lutz, Nick Foles grabbed his helmet, looked at his teammates, and said, "Let's go."
Well, no question, Foles has done it before. It's going to be harder with Peters sideline. Halapulavati Vaitai, Big V. He started at left tackle the entire postseason last year because Peters was hurt, but coming into a game in the fourth quarter is a lot harder.
He's always better if he has a week to prepare for a game than coming in cold like this, but he'll have to be good now.
Eagles offense has not done much since the first quarter. Foles, four-man rush. He's got time. He's got a completion. It's Jeffrey who gets bulldozed backwards by DeMario Davis. And it'll bring up second down. Sees it, throws, incomplete. Aguilar was open, but he never turned around. And a third and five.
I think Nick Foles felt like he had to get rid of it, a count early before Aguilar could be set for it. See, he feels that little bit of pressure coming off of his left side, and Aguilar is still looking, and the ball's already gone. Nice coverage by Von Bell. Cam Jordan has been switching sides for pass rush now with Vaitai on the field and Peters out. Let's see if he goes there again.
He will. Play clock down to three. They get it off. Foles stands in, throws incomplete. It was high. Tried to get it to Hurst, and now a late flag from the secondary, so hang on.
Pass interference, number 26, defense, automatic, first down.
That's P.J. Williams, who had the coverage on Zach Ertz, the tight end.
And instead of a linebacker covering Zach Ertz, they go with the defensive back, P.J. Williams, and he grabs him there, and the ball's in the air. You can see where the call could be made. It's been a lot of hand fighting. The way he grabbed him off the line of scrimmage and had him wrapped up, I can understand why the flag came out.
And so it is a first down. On the fake, Foles to throw it, trying to get Ertz involved, but a good tackle. There is Davis, who has been an absolute star of a free agent signing. 3-year, $24 million deal from the Jets. He's been excellent. He led the team in tackles. He's also been one of their leaders.
And Kevin, as this clock ticks down, there's still plenty of opportunity for the Eagles to run the football, but it feels like Doug Peterson doesn't think he's going to get much done there. So the ball will be in the air way more times than not.
Four-man rush. Foles hangs in, throws. Incomplete. He tried to get into Tate, but Eli Apple with a nice play.
I would say a change of scenery has done that young man's career a whole lot of good. Talk about Eli Apple, number 25. Former first-round pick of the New York Giants. Really struggled there, both on the field, in the locker room with teammates, off the field. Since coming to New Orleans, he's played very well.
Third and eight, it's a blitz. Foles stands in, throws, incomplete. Tried to get it to Jordan Matthews with a touchdown earlier. Could not connect, and here comes a punt for Philadelphia.
And Dennis Allen, the defensive coordinator, went after him. Not necessarily just flat-out pass rush, but everything was man-to-man coverage with a free safety in the middle, what they call cover one. And there was a battle, P.J. Williams and Jordan Matthews. Matthews got him earlier in the game for a touchdown. P.J. Williams won that one.
Johnson to punt it away. Tommy Lee Lewis calls fair catch, does so at the 25 with 8:38 to go. Saints up by six with the football. Back to New Orleans in a moment. Saints defense has been absolutely fantastic since the first quarter. The Saints have a 20-14 lead, 8 minutes 38 seconds to go. It's a one possession game right now, but a field goal would certainly change that.
Totally. In the last possession, the Eagles had a field goal cushion that they could play with, and they took it. Saints got three. There is no cushion now. They can't let it become a 9 point or more game.
Had two sacks in this game early. And Fletcher Cox trying to give it a go, but on the sideline still. Breeze, quick pass. It's another one from Michael Thomas. And he is parks his way all the way out for a gain of 9 to the 34. His 11th catch for 149 yards. And that will be a new Saints postseason single game record. Wow.
And I really feel for Jim Schwartz right now, the defensive coordinator, because every instinct is probably telling him to bring pressure at Drew Brees. But he also understands how fast the ball gets away. And to isolate some of the guys he has in coverage, he doesn't feel like that's a good gamble. Thus continues to rush four and try and drop more people.
Kamara in the backfield. They're going to sneak with Brees, and I believe the forward momentum will get him there. Took a pretty good shot from Michael Bennett. Well, that should be a first down, and it is. And Fletcher Cox will come back in the game.
An absolute gamer right there. Do you remember the Rams game earlier this year where he hurt a hip, left the ball game? They thought he might be done for the night. Made it back in and got a key sack on Jared Goff. Just seeing him come on the field has to help their defense.
Taysom Hill back in the game. Haven't seen him in a while. lined up as a blocker here. They're going to run, and Ingram has a short game. Michael Bennett really blew that play up.
He just took, I think it was the tight end trying to block. It looked like Josh Hill. And watch how he just takes his arms and his hands and extends Hill back into the backfield. And now Mark Ingram's having to make a decision about where to try and go. And Bennett almost corralled him with one hand.
We have an injured Eagle on the play. Avante Maddox, the cornerback. And they go out and tend to him.
He hurt his knee in the last game against the New Orleans Saints here.
Had to miss a few weeks after that. So while they tend to Maddox, take a look at some of the things that have gone on in this divisional round with some divisional round headlines. The Chiefs ended the Colts' luck in their great season. Patrick Mahomes and the run game and the defense all great. Los Angeles Rams had a 100-yard rushing game from Gurley and Anderson and beat down the Cowboys. And then this, to me, is absolutely stunning. 8 straight title games for the New England Patriots after they absolutely lambasted the Chargers today.
You realize the league is not built for someone going to the title game 8 straight times, right? With the way schedules are and playing the first place schedule every year, that is a phenomenal accomplishment by New England.
Of course, that schedule brought to you by Intuit TurboTax. And here's Breeze. Pressure from Cox back in the game. Breeze gets it to the hill and going to be tagged for a loss by Malcolm Jenkins. Fletcher Cox playing hurt, comes back in and makes a huge play.
That was a tag team play, wasn't it? Cox putting the pressure on Drew Breeze, disrupting the timing of this screen because Breeze can't throw it when he wants to. Has to delay it and extend it and allows Malcolm Jenkins to get into excellent position to make the play in the open field tackle.
So with 6:19 and counting, it's a 3rd and 13 for New Orleans. They got to get out to the 45-yard line. Four-man rush. Breeze firing Thomas. He's got it again! First down, New Orleans. My goodness. 12 catches for Thomas today, 171 yards.
And I think this route was run in pre-snap, meaning Drew Breeze looked and saw where the coverage was and knew with that route it would take him to Josh Hawkins, who's a backup cornerback, mainly a special teams player in his time in the NFL. And he loved his matchup. If he can get Michael Thomas on Josh Hawkins, he's going to throw it almost no matter what and let Thomas make a play on the ball.
Monster game for Michael Thomas. Avante Maddox. So Hawkins in for him. Now Maddox is back and it's a huge pickup. Kamara, what a cut on a dime. First down, New Orleans. Just so good at running clock when they have the lead. And now they're looking for another score. 13 on the run to Kamara.
And we talked about the offensive line needing to pick up the pace in terms of running the football. I think that they've done that quite well down the stretch.
Well, to that point, Charles, Saints have 128 yards rushing. And you know, you look at this game in the at halftime, you didn't think there's any way they'd get there. And yeah, your point is, look at all the clock they're milking, right?
Exactly. This is a veteran quarterback who understands how it's going now, where they are on this point of the field, score of the game. He's not going to snap the ball until it's inside.
They will run it to Kamara. That time, not much doing. Jordan Hicks was there on the tap. Keep in mind, not only the score and the time, but the timeout situation for the Eagles. They only have 2.
Yeah, remember, they took that first one early in the third quarter when the crowd noise got them. They took the timeout instead of taking the 5-yard penalty. They may need that timeout down the stretch. We shall see. But no hurry right now for New Orleans coming out of the huddle. They want to make sure that ball snapped inside of 5 seconds each time on the play clock.
Breeze to throw it. Looks right, not there. Gets hit as he throws to Ingram, who was tackled immediately by Jordan Hicks. And so another pivotal third down for this Philadelphia defense.
And in this situation, this point on the field, most defensive coordinators, because once you get to the 35, they feel like they're almost conceding a field goal.
So in order to try and get them out of it in this spot, this is often where you bring pressure. Try and get something on the quarterback and get a lost yardage play to make it tougher on the field goal kicker.
Would you do it here?
I think it's well worth it at this point for the Philadelphia Eagles. Laying back has not worked very well for them.
See if they agree. 3rd and 8, and now a timeout by New Orleans as the play clock was down to 2 seconds. Now they'll talk this over on this 3rd and 8. You know what's interesting, Charles, is you think Saints, you think Drew Brees and the third best offense, and they are all of that. But what the Saints really become in the last month of the season, what they're showing you today, it's the best defense they've had in a long, long time.
And Sean Payton's actually able to call a game based on that. In the past, he's had to call a game based on, okay, we've got to outscore everyone we play.
Right.
Not anymore. With that defense, able to run, adjust as the game goes along, take care of the football, and milk the clock. Unusual football, but winning football thus far.
I mean,
think
about how the game started. It was 14-0 for you could blink Philadelphia, and guys were running free, and there was... And I think you do have to go back to the fake punt in their own territory from their own 30.
The guts to call it in that situation, go to Sean Payton, and people will criticize Doug Peterson, but no coach that I know was going to take that penalty there at that point on the field.
Eagles have to have this if they want a chance. 3rd and 8. Brees has been unconscious. They'll run it here to Kamara, who play gets blown up. And that is a big play from Michael Bennett, because that turns into a really long field goal now.
It turned into the play that they wanted, the lost yardage play. Bennett, the 3-time Pro Bowler, controls Max Unger, sheds him, and gives Alvin Kamara nowhere to go. What a huge play. We think of Bennett in his pass rush. This run stopping that we've seen in this last series, tremendous for the Philadelphia Eagles.
So here, after a loss of 3 on the play, is Lutz. It's certainly well within his range, but it's no gimme. 2 of 3 of 50-yard field goals plus on the season. And this should be about a 52-yarder. And that's what it will be. It'll be a 52-yard try for Will Lutz to make it a 2-possession game. The kick is no good! And so the Eagles still have life.
And all because of the defense making that last play to make this a much tougher field goal. Lutz pushes it off to the right. So if the Eagles come back and make this thing happen, you mark down the play Michael Bennett made on 3rd down.
Charles, we came on the air talking about not only the Saints and the number 1 seed, but Foles' magic and how he has won 4 straight playoff games, Super Bowl MVP, and he does it so coolly and calmly. He did it last week, scoring with under a minute left to come from behind win. Can he do it one more time? 2:58 to play, 1 timeout for Philly. They're down by 6. Foles has time, still looking incomplete. There was no one open. He tried to get it to Golden Tate, and a 2nd and 10.
New Orleans continues on the path they've been in the second half. These wide receivers and tight end will have to win their routes individually against tighter coverage.
Blitz coming. Picked up. Foles guns it. Caught. It's Ertz. 1st down. Great blitz pickup, too, by Sproles. It allowed it to happen.
They brought the pressure, but they didn't disrupt Zach Ertz off the line of scrimmage. He's getting an absolute free release into the secondary, and he's a tight end running routes just like a wide receiver and beats Von Bell inside.
Back to pass again. Stands in. Lofty one. Incomplete. And that was a danger zone. Trying to get it to Ertz. Von Bell came over to try and knock it away. And a penalty back by the quarterback.
to hang on.
Personal foul, roughing the passer. Number 92, defense, 15-yard penalty, automatic. First down.
That's on the rookie Marcus Davenport, 15 yards.
You know, he got roughing the passer calls in both of the Carolina games. And here's another one. He gets his hands right up into the neck and the head area of Nick Foles. An easy call for the officials. Puts his team in a tough spot.
Plenty of time.
If I'm New Orleans, I'm not giving Alshon Jeffrey or Zach Ertz any free releases. I need a body in front of them at all times.
And that's what they're doing. They have Lattimore up on the line against Jeffrey at the bottom of your screen. They'll run it to Sproles. And not too much there, if anything. Stacked up by the Saints, and I imagine the Eagles content to let it run down. That's the conundrum, right? You obviously need to score to win, but you don't want to leave a minute and a half for Drew Brees.
You're trying to score as the clock's hit zero. And they took the extra point.
We get this off with a two-minute warning. A little surprise. Foles back, throws. Intercepted! Went right through Jeffrey's hands! It's Lattimore! Jeffrey's hands and Lattimore's second pick of the game, and the Saints looking to move on. Alshon Jeffrey has some of the best hands in the league, and he just missed it.
I mean, absolutely right through the wickets, and Marshawn Lattimore has done a tremendous job covering him the last half of this game. That wasn't one of them. That was a completion. But how about the hand-eye coordination of Lattimore to get the interception off the tip?
They're run to Kamara. Eagles have one timeout. They'll likely use it here. If you're wondering why, technically the Eagles could still get it back with, I don't know, like 10 seconds left. Here's Doug Peterson consoling Jeffrey, who obviously has been such a huge part of this team, including the Super Bowl run last year.
Yeah, played hurt throughout that Super Bowl run, ended up getting offseason shoulder surgery to correct the issue.
He lay on the turf for a solid minute.
Look at Nick Foles talking to him. The two basketball guys who have a great connection, and Marshawn Lattimore deservedly getting to celebrate with the takeaway there.
Two interceptions today, and again, the Saints first down will officially, like I said, if not, maybe the Eagles can go for a punt block return. It would be barely any time left. New Orleans been a hard-fought game. They have really controlled it since the first quarter, looking to seal it now.
Mike 50. Ready,
Kamara on the run, and he is taken down immediately as the clock obviously will run. As you talked about, that early second half timeout, certainly a factor for Philadelphia.
And you see the Saints understanding that they say, hey, we may have to still play this thing out on defense. And they don't start celebrating just yet. And if you're going to throw one in the end zone, you would think number 17 might have a chance of redemption if indeed it gets to that.
Mm-hmm. That's what Dennis Allen's talking about in the middle. Jeffrey hoping for one last shot. It's a 3rd and 10 for the Saints. Trying to move on, and they would host the Rams next week if they could do it. Clock down at 2. They will run it. Kamara, big hit on Kamara, and that will do it. Official. The defending Super Bowl champs, what an effort to get back here. But the Saints, a little too much today. And the number one seed will move on to the conference championship against the Rams right here next week. What a game.
How about that? Number one versus number two next week. Number one versus number two over in the AFC.
How about the emotion of Nick Foles, Super Bowl MVP? Couldn't have played better 2 years in a row for the injured Carson Wentz, and he doesn't know that he'll be here anymore.
I'd say the chances are good that he will not be here, but there will be a huge market of people looking to have Nick Foles quarterbacking their team next year.
Saints were down 14-0 and came all the way back, and they earned it today. They knocked the champs out, and they show you why they were the number one seed. A hard-fought 20-14 win, the largest postseason comeback in Saints history, and two really good coaches hug it out. So the Saints with a 20-14 win. Couple of Westlake High School kids on the head shake. And now New Orleans will host the Rams in the title game next week. That was the pivotal play to essentially seal it. Back from New Orleans in a moment.